Hi, I'm Sandy from parkerlings.com, and I'm here today to show you a quick process video for how I made this card using scrap pieces of paper from my Christmas card making. So come along and see how I made this card. To make this card, you'll start out with a card base that it measures 6 by 12. This will give you, when you fold, score it and fold it in half, it will give you a 6 by 6 square card. So you'll fold the card in half. You can use a bone folder or another tool to get your score pressed very crisp and cleanly. So a 6 by 6 card base is what we will use to start out with. You'll also want a piece of black cardstock that you can make some half inch strips. These will be used as a frame on the main piece of the card. Okay, my strips, I will cut them to size, you know, as I put them on later in the project. You're also going to want, my secret is a large, is double-sided adhesive. Now you can buy these in sheets, but I have this large roll of double-sided adhesive that I am going to cut to size. So I will just take it and I'm going to cut 5 inches. So I will use my mat here and just make sure that I'm getting 5 inches. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then I will just use my scissors to cut at the 5 inch mark. Now you can, what you can plan to do is initially get it cut, but you will have to trim it to make it the 5 by 5 after you've put, sorry for my arm, put the strips of paper down. And so you don't have to be precise. You don't have to be terribly precise with this 5 inches, but you don't want to waste your adhesive. So, you know, getting as close as you can is a good thing. And just cut as straight a line as you can. Again, it's not, I don't have nonstick scissors, so it's a little bit tricky. Just do the best you can. Now, I bought this off of eBay. It's 6 inches wide, and I bought it well over a year ago, probably 2 years ago. I will see if I can find the company that I bought it from on eBay, so that I can share it with you. And if I find it, I will put it in the description box below the video. But it's a wonderful thing to have, this big roll of double-sided adhesive. The other thing that makes this project then are paper strips. Now, the paper strips that I'm using are 1/2 inch wide, and they are actually the strips that come off of the paper pad that I use to make my a bunch of my Christmas cards. So rather than throwing away the little decorative strips that were at the top of the pad, I simply kept them and kept them in a, with all of my scraps in a scrap bin. You can see the jar here. And now I'm basically using up my scraps. The paper pad that I used this year is the Pebbles Cozy and Bright pack. It was 48 papers of 12 by 12. And I got it, I think this was bought at Tuesday morning for $6.99. So it was an excellent price. And I've mainly used up the entire pack other than a few scraps, because I made Christmas ornament gift boxes. So here you can see some of the Christmas ornament boxes that I made. If you want to see a tutorial of how I made these, let me know in the comments below, and I'm happy to pull a video together showing that. But they're real easy. Making gift boxes is real easy. And inside each of these is an air dry clay Christmas ornament that my seniors group that I work with made up, and we're giving them at our church to the Sunday school students and to the shut-ins of our church. So looking forward to doing that later this month. So anyway, having made all the 18 of those gift boxes from the cardstock in the paper pad, I then had larger strips of the paper left over, which I then used to make Christmas cards using larger pieces of the paper. And then I had all of the scraps left over and all of these little paper strips. And so these paper strips now are what I am using to make the rest of these cards. And so it's very straightforward. There's very little cutting involved initially. The idea is that you use the scraps to build up the card. So I like to go on the diagonal, like you saw in my original card. And what all you do is you set the papers onto the strips. I start in the center in the longest part, and I'll build this one out. This is obviously adhesive side up. And I'm just sticking the strips to the adhesive. If I can find it, I've got another one of the same style, and I'll just continue my pattern. Now you may find that it's up to you how you decide to match them up or whatever. But by the time you've used up the paper, it's such a busy pattern. Any of this pattern piecing in some of the longer edges won't really matter. And then I just work to try to coordinate, making sure that I've got like this is a red one, making sure then that my next one is more of a green color. And I leave a little bit of gap in between the strips, but I just eyeball the gap. I'm not terribly precise, and I do try to get any of the residual glue off of the strips, because these were the strips that were keeping the paper in the pad, glued into the pad. There is a bit of residual glue, so I try to carefully get that removed as well. So now you'll see here, I'm just going to go, and you see that there's the cut from the center there, and I am just, I'll just put that over the edge so that then it's not visible. And I'm just leaving a little gap in between each of the strips, because that's what I'll then use for the gold glitter as a bit of extra bling on the card. And I just keep doing this with the strips, trying to, where possible, matching up. I'll just speed this part up then and show you the finished result in the next step. And there you have it. I've covered the whole piece with strips, and now I do still have sticky bits in between, and that is where we will then put the gold glitter. But before I do that, I'm going to go around and cut these strips off so that I can see my square. So to cut them off, it's real nice and easy. I just butt my scissors up against the double-sided adhesive and cut along the edge, and each piece comes off. You could use a trimmer, and you'll see that in a minute I will be going ahead to use a trimmer, but I prefer just to use scissors because these are little, you know, these pieces are small enough that it makes it easier for me to see where my double-sided adhesive is. Now, it is easy enough. Once I've got the first strip cut, it will then be easy enough to put it into my trimmer to trim the rest of the pieces. So if I go into the trimmer, you see here I can put this particular row, this row here then, just into the trimmer and trim it off real easy here. Just like so. And you can save, especially some of the longer pieces, they can be saved for strips on the next one. And you can keep going and going for quite a few cards you can end up making with this method. And of course, you could use a piece of paper to cut strips to do this design. But the reality is, it's all about just being frugal and using up the scraps. It's up to you exactly how you decide to create the strips and get the strips of paper. There we go. There are my strips cut back. And now I have got this square. I'm going to cut. As I make my cuts, I am going to basically cut a little bit on each side just to make sure I have a nice crisp edge on every side. And these strips as well are strips that you can go ahead and use in cards. You can use these strips too. So let's just set them aside and you can use them in another project. So this was 6. I'm going to cut this down to 5.5, and it'll make a half inch strip then. Because ultimately I'm going for a square that is 5x5. And you can see on this one in particular that it wasn't very, it's narrower here than it is here. It's narrower at the bottom than it is at the top. And finally, excellent. And now my square, which is fairly square, measures 5x5. And that will then fit onto my card base. And it looks like it has a large border, but remember, we will use these black strips to make a frame. The next step is to fill in the adhesive gaps on this panel. So here we are. I'm using a coffee filter to collect my glitter, and I'm just going to open the glitter bottle, and I'm going to be vigorous with my, or liberal with my glitter. I am focusing the glitter on the adhesive in between the strips. And remember, I was just eyeballing it. I wasn't being terribly precise. But now what I'll do is I will tap all of the glitter. I will tap all of the glitter off onto my coffee filter. Sorry, I'll try to do that so that you can see it. Tap it all off. Of course, you'll get glitter a little bit everywhere, but I guess that's part of the beauty of doing it. Now, I'm also going to wipe to make sure that all of the glitter is on the strips securely. And that also allows me to wipe the glitter off of the paper itself. So, because of course I didn't want to use a static powder tool on the basis that if I did that, then the self-adhesive would end up having powder on it and wouldn't stick. So what you're seeing here then is me getting the glitter affixed to the adhesive firmly so that we don't have too much fall off when the recipient receives the card. They'll just have the glitter. They won't have the mess. They'll have a very limited amount of mess by the time they get it, because we still have a bit more to do on the card, so any additional residue will stay at my house and not at the recipient's house. There we go. Okay, so now I will put my glitter back into the bottle as much as possible. Now, this part may get cut out of the video because it's a messy part. There we go. Not too bad. Not too bad. And you can, of course, make sure you close the glitter before you do too much else. And I'll do the same thing here on the edge where I see some glitter got. And ultimately, if it's on your hands, on your clothes, well, you've been working. It's a sign that you've been creating. The next thing we need to do is find a sentiment. Now, I bulk made my sentiments early in my Christmas card making process this year, put a bunch of dies through the die cut machine, and made various sentiments. So here you see, I should do it this way. Here you see Christmas blessings, and I've got Merry Christmas and joy. And I colored and stamped, you know, etc. Here are some rectangular Merry Christmas on a larger piece of paper. I also did some of the some mirror card, which would then allow me to put a background on. And I think that this is the one I'm going to use for this card. This Merry Christmas rectangular shape. So what I will do is add that to my pile of bits, put the rest of them away. The next bit that I'm going to prep is the embellishment. If you remember back to my card originally, I have this ribbon. This is secured with a brad. And I have the matching, I had gotten the matching decorative brads embellishments for this same pebbles design. And, you know, it's interesting. I think I got this quite in two separate sessions. I didn't deliberately do it, but I found out that they were a match, which was wonderful. So these are the embellished brads. There were 26 of them on the sheet. And it's the same pebbles, cozy and bright design. Again, these are several years old. I got them at Tuesday morning, and you may or may not be able to find the same set that I'm using. But I'm going to pick off a, putting my original card away. I'm going to pick off a brad that will match my card. And of course, they'll all match. But I think for this one, I'm going to go ahead and use a white brad. You know what? I think I'm going to go ahead and use the red brad. Why not? I'll use the red one. And baker's twine. So having decided that the panel is a bit directional with the houses on this piece strip and the candy canes, I want those to be facing up. I'm going to put a hole in the lower corner, and that hole will be where my brad will feed through. So if I turn it my way just a second here, you'll be looking upside down for just a second, but that's okay. Well, no, I'll keep it this way. So that is the lower corner. I've got my brad here, and I've got a piece of baker's twine. I'm going to simply loop the baker's twine as many times as it will allow. And I think each loop is probably about an inch. Just over an inch. It doesn't need to be precise. You don't want them too big or too small, but then again, you can use your best judgment in terms of the size, about an inch will be the loops, and you can use your eye to decide how they should look. Okay, so now here I've got my loops. I've then got my brad, and I'm opening fairly far, and I'm just going to stick the center of the baker's twine into the loop, into the brad, and then secure the brad, tighten the pieces of the brad up. Like so. And then I will pop the brad pieces through, pushing it down to tighten it as much as I can without hurting too badly. And then I will tighten the brad down. Now, you don't have to tighten the brad down too hard at this point, because you do still have to take the double-sided adhesive off the back eventually. But we've got a few more steps. But now that is all put on, and we'll get that cleaned up and tidied up and so on in a bit. But what's nice about that is that then it is hidden, the brad is hidden between the panels, and you don't see it on the inside of the card at all. You don't have to put a hole through the inside of the card to show it. So that's what's so nice. That's what's so nice about doing the brad in that way. I'll show you how I frame out with the black this main panel. Flipping it over, I'm going to get each edge and fold over the double-sided adhesive. This is where, if you've got nails, it's great. Fortunately, my thumbnails are fairly long yet. So here you can see the back of the thing. I'm just going to fold over the double-sided adhesive, and I'm going to take one of my black frame pieces and set it down, and I'm going to set it, I can set one corner to be pretty much on the edge, but because I'm going to miter the edges, I want to bring it forward about a half an inch or so, bring it down about a half an inch or so from the edge. And then, and this is where it might be easier actually to flip it over, because you want to make sure that as you're doing it, you want to make sure that you've got an even amount of framing all the way along. And so if I do it like that, you can see I've got a good frame. And then you can just put your finger on it just to kind of secure it where it needs to go. And then you can fold the adhesive back over itself for now, for a moment. And now what we can do is miter the edges. So to miter the corner, I'm going to cut at keeping the angle of the corner. I'm just going to basically extend the corner. And so I'm going to cut at what it would effectively be a 45 degree angle, and then cut down right alongside the panel for the rest of the black. Like so. And that gives me, you can see, that gives me a 45 degree angle, which is great. And now I can do the same thing on the other side. I can simply extend the corner and then cut off the bit. So it goes like that. Okay. And now we'll continue to do all three sides just like that. Flip it over. Now it'll be easier to pick up the adhesive. Go ahead and fold it. Fold the adhesive over. Take your strip. And now with this strip, it's nice and easy, because all you have to do is line up the corner, and so that you've got what is effectively a mitered edge. And that will give you both a good mitered edge and the same, it kind of guarantees you the same distance spacing as the previous piece, so that you get a good straight line. And now you can see there's the mitered corner of the frame. Okay, so then I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to pop the paper back and then come back over here and cut my strip, extending my corner like so. I think my angle was just a little bit off. There we go. Extending my corner like so, and then cutting off the other edge up to the corner like so. There we go. And then we'll just do the same thing again. This one, of course, you've got to line up the two corners, which is fine. There you go. You simply make sure. You're simply making sure that the edges align. And they do. There we go. Firming it up. Folding this back for a moment. So then you can cut off, and at this one, you just cut on the outside edge of your previous piece, like so. And there, now, you have your panel all framed out. And you would never know that you have a faux mitered edge on each of the corners. They look quite real. They look proper mitered edges. Okay, so now I'm going to stick my panel to my card base. I'm going to stick my panel to my card base. So that's fairly straightforward. The big thing is getting around the brad that you placed earlier. And to do that, you know, if you tear it a little bit, but then what you can do is secure your brad back down to the double-sided adhesive, like so. That helps to further secure the brad. So make sure that you're in the right spot, that you're at the right angle. You then will carefully line up. I'm not perfectly straight, but it's straight enough. And that then is your panel on your card front. And you will make it straighter because you will be working right over your piece. But because of the camera, I'm not working right over my piece. So it's not quite the same for me. But there you can see. And now finally is the embellishment. And for the embellishment, I'm going to glue the Merry Christmas. I'm going to glue the Merry Christmas to the mirror card, just using a glue stick that I'm liberally applying. And eyeballing the centering of it as best I can. Here we go. And then what I will do is I will add some foam squares to the back to be able to slightly pop up the sentiment. And I'm just using up what I've got at this stage because I'm at the end of my card making. So I'm just using these little squares. You could use foam tape that you would cut off of a roll if you have it, or you could use larger squares if you've got them. Like I said, I'm just using what I've got. And I just put a few around like you can see there. I will then use, I have a pokey tool that helps to take the stickers off. So I'll get them taken off. They come off fairly easily, actually, for me. Okay. And then what I will do is pop my sentiment just into the upper portion of the card, like so. Press it down to make sure it's secured. And there you have the card front. Now to finish the inside of the card, what I will do is pop a random strip of this paper that I have. Nearly any of them will do. I like this one. I'll pop a strip in the middle. I'm just going to cut off the little rounded bottom, which was from the hole that was in the middle of the strip, Oh, and this is a little bit longer than 6 inches, so I'm just going to cut it down. There we go. Now it should fit. There we go. It fits. I'm going to use a glue strip to secure it. Making sure I'm on the correct page. And this one is not directional, so it doesn't matter too much. I'm trying to make sure that it is centered on the page as much as possible. And then I will take my insert. I bulk stamped my inserts, and I will glue them in. And the inserts are 5.5 inches. They are an 8.5 by 11 inch piece of paper cut into 4. And so it gives me a larger border on the top and bottom, but that's all right. So again, I will use a glue stick to glue that in as well. How are you doing with your card making? Have you made your Christmas cards? Do you have some Christmas cards still to do before the big day? I'd love to hear how you get on if you go ahead and make a card like this. It's nothing new. I have seen other YouTubers do cards like this. But I'd be interested to see your take on this card. That is the inside done. That's the outside done. What I have left is to put my handmade stamp on the back to let people know that I made it. Of course, they probably will be able to tell that I made it because it's not exactly perfect, but that's okay. I'll get that added to the bottom center. And I've just done that in black. I use the VersaFine Onyx Black, and my stamp was a custom stamp that my husband had made for me. I will put the link, if I'm able to find the site that he used to make it, I will put the link in the description. It might be something that it certainly would be a good Christmas gift, although we're probably getting a little bit too late in the year for 2022, but maybe 2023 for Christmas or for a birthday, you can think about asking for one if you are a regular crafter. Mine says Handmade with Love by Sandy. So that is my card then finished. And now what I will do is do a final little bit of decoration on my envelope. I've got two things that I'm doing with my envelopes this year. First of all, I've got these clear wreath stickers. I'm adding one of those to the back of the card, to the back of the envelope to decorate that. And on the front, I will glue one of my paper strips just to give it a finished look. Make it a flag, and then I will, making sure I'm on the right, I'm going to put that on the left-hand side. And again, I'm just going to use a glue stick to get that glued down. I'm sure you could use other craft tape if you wanted to, or you could use use a piece of double stick tape to secure it. That's completely up to you. I find that the glue stick works best for me. And there we go. So that then is my finished card. I hope you've enjoyed this bit of a process video. If you have enjoyed it, do me a favor and like the video and subscribe to the channel. Leave a comment in the comments boxes below so that I know that I should video my process for making other cards. So that's all for today. I've been Sandy Parker from parkerlings.com. I hope that you've enjoyed the video, and I hope to see you again soon. Take care. God bless. Bye-bye.